Harris.
Yeah, I've got a source on this. It's very interesting. He's one of our security experts, Bob Newman. We've had him on Fox News Channel before. I've just got off the phone with him. He is a skydiver. He is currently in Colorado right now. And he gave me a little bit of hope, a little bit of good news here, guys, in terms of the conditions. Remember, we were worried about how cold this child might be. He said it's actually a nice day in Denver today. He said it's about 70 degrees. So he would be probably okay at this point. He's about 2,000 feet in the air. He said that they're watching this very closely from a skydiver perspective. It's kind of all the rage among those people who do that for a living. He said that he believes this disc is made out of mylar. It was tied to the ground, and if you look closely, you can see the tether line that was untied when this child was able to access this through a gate, untie it, and then it flew away. Good information, 2,000 feet. I'm now connecting Bob with the people at the FAA because they wanted to know if there was anybody out there who could give them good information from the perspective of a skydiver, somebody who would have the ability just to from ground to air look. So as I connect those two sources, I'll come back and hopefully have more information for you.
All right. Well, that's great news to hear. It's a warm day, an unusually warm day this time of year in Colorado, about 70 degrees. And if it's flying at 2,000 feet as opposed to 10,000 feet, then the air is less thin. Yeah. It is not as cold. And the child who is trapped inside this, you know, homemade device, a balloon that is going at a pretty quick pace in the air, may be okay. It's just hard to know right now.
Yeah, on the phone right now, we have the Larimer County Sheriff's Spokeswoman, Eloise Campanella. Ms. Campanella, what can you tell us? And can you confirm for us, do we know that this boy is definitely in this balloon?
As far as we can ascertain, yes, he is inside the balloon. His older brother reported to us that he watched him go into the access door just as the device was taking off. We do have people on the ground, though, doing a search just to make sure that he's not hiding somewhere, maybe afraid that the balloon took off.
Let's hope he is hiding somewhere.
Yes, to the best of our knowledge, though, he is inside the balloon. And it is, as I heard you reporting earlier, it is a nice day here in Colorado, which is good. We have help from the Denver news media. They have offered us their helicopters, which they are now coordinating with the FAA on what needs to be done. We are in contact with Warren Air Force Base and with different balloon companies trying to figure out how we can get this device down. I'm not sure if it's mylar on the outside. It has been reported to us that it was actually a charged foil. Whether that is true or not, we don't know at this time, but certainly that comes into play when we're trying to figure out how to handle this situation. Frankly, we're at a loss, but we are contacting everyone that might have some information for us on how to handle it.
Let me ask you this. Did the boy, the brother, who belongs to this thing? I mean, who built this thing? Is there a father involved in this? And what does he know about what's inside that little pocket area that this boy is in? Are there controls in there? Is there a way to make this thing go in any particular direction?
I don't know about what's in there. It was built by the father. We are unable to communicate with this child. Even if we were to be able to ascertain that there is some way that he could get it down himself, we are unable to communicate with him. So obviously everyone is working with the father about what it's made of, what's in there. It does have the capability of going as high as 10,000 feet, but it seems like for the time being at least it's maintaining its level. So again, we're just contacting everyone that we can think of to try and figure out how to get this boy down.
Is there any rescue attempt underway? I mean, is there any, you know, vehicle that is scrambling to get near this to try anything at this point, or are we still trying to figure out how to do it?
Of course. I mean, we're tracking it. We've got helicopters in the air. We're still not sure exactly what we need to do to get it down. We don't want to do anything that's going to jeopardize the child even more.
Would a helicopter cause disturbance of the wind and thus affect the flight of the balloon?
It could, and these are all things that we're taking into account. The helicopters at this point are tracking it while we are here on the ground trying to figure out what to do with it. So the helicopters are at least keeping an eye on it for us.
Can you tell whether sometimes it looks like it's very, very high in the sky. Other times it appears as though it's getting closer and closer to the ground. Can you tell us?
I'm not sure about that unless it's the helicopter itself that is moving around it. I think it's kind of maintaining at the level that it is, right around 2,000 feet.
How did the balloon escape? Do you know?
The tethers came loose. Beyond that, we don't know. And at this point, to be honest with you, we're more concerned about getting the child down than figuring out how it happened.
Yeah.
So,
yeah,
okay, we'll keep you posted.
All right, Louise Campanella, good luck to you and your folks
Thank
there.
You.